Hi, my name is Mitch Ripke, and today I'm going to show you a 2002 Terry fifth wheel that we've got here. Really nice unit, greatly priced. I want to also let you know that I work on commission, so please do me a favor and come in and ask for me when you get here. My number is 541-514-1332. With that being said, come on over and let's take a look at this. So we've got down underneath of here is going to be the storage compartment that contains the sewer hose and just a number of different things that you can sit in there related to the unit itself. We'll come back over here. You can see that it's got an awning. This is a manual awning on this unit right here. This will stretch out to where it's about 10 to 12 feet out and create a nice little cover for you so you can sit outside underneath some chairs if you like. You can also take the feet off as well and put them down so you could make a straight out awning rather than have an angle where someone may potentially hit their head on it or whatnot, but you do have that as an option. There's another little storage unit over here, and you can see that the people actually have the blocks in here. This is for leveling out your unit when you're parked. So you can put these two, three, four at a time, whatever is necessary to make sure that you're sitting level on the particular unit. This is a tandem axle unit as well, so you can see it's got great weight distribution that it can handle. We'll come back here. Triple steps to be able to get in and out. It's got the little handlebar here. As you can see up here too, this is a Freedom Edition. It's a 24C. We'll come back here at the back. Got a nice spare tire on here. Of course, this is your reefer vent for your Dometic refrigerator that's inside. You have an auxiliary shower out here as well. That's what's down inside of here. And your bumper is going to be the storage where a person could potentially, if you'd like, store your sewer hose down in there. Got a nice ladder to be able to access up on top of the roof to be able to check your seals and stuff like that, which people should do at least yearly. Come on around to the side over here. Got your power cord right down here. Got your little glass bulb levelers here. This is where you're going to hook up your water, and then you also have a flush as well so you can flush your tanks. Nice little slide out so you'll gain a little bit more room in the front. This out of the way here so you can go by. All right, here I've got your dual propane tanks, which makes it really nice, and you have a valve right here so that when one of the tanks gets low or runs out, you'll use this valve and you can switch it over to the other tank. And this little dial in here, as you can see, this is orange, but when this is your tank is full, this will be green. So that's how you'll know how to be able to switch. So let's go on around and we'll head inside the unit. Oh, one thing before we head inside, there's a button over here which is actually for the landing control system, so it's a powered, so this will elevate these up and down by power. Alright, let's head on in here. Get you on up inside, and we'll go at this in reverse. So come on up here. Take a look in the back here. We've got a really nice king size bed. This was an additional bed. It's not the original. Underneath of that bed, there's going to be some storage as well. There is storage on the left and the right hand side, as you can see, and above the overhead. Over here is a sink, so you can do some cleaning over here in this area. And there's some more storage above that as well. And then over here, we're going to run in. You can see the bathroom, the shower. Got a nice little skylight in there. Here's some more storage space. You can see this unit contains the original books that came with it. Gives you a little bit of extra storage there. Got a TV space up here up top where you could set a TV. This unit, being the age that it was, contained the old CRT TV. You could put a flat screen mount up here as well, so you could set a flat screen or just stand one up there. And it's got a TV and cable connection up there as well. There's some more storage up here. And then we'll go down here to the table. this table's got storage spaces underneath of it. I mean, the couch does, sorry. And then the table itself will go down and this will create a bed. These over here, these go behind the awning. I mean, behind the slide out, excuse me. When the slide out comes in, you set these behind it to prop it so that it doesn't, if there's a safety issue or whatnot, it doesn't open accidentally. So we'll look at that. You can see the slide out here. This unit is open and it's got a nice little couch here. The couch will come out and lay down into a bed. So you've got this little sleeping area here. You can see over this way, got a microwave up here. Check the microwave out. We've got the heat hood as well for the stove. There's your propane stove. There's also a nice little oven in here, which makes it nice if you want to do some broiling or different things like that. You've got the oven. Your control panels and stuff down here, as far as your breakers and your fuse boxes, are down here below. There's a nice little bit of storage underneath of here. You can see that there's the pumps and whatnot back there, but you still do have some storage. Another nice little thing about this unit is it's got the stainless steel dual sink, and these are actually pretty good size compared to a lot of the other units out there. You can see the storage above here as well. Pretty decent amount of storage here. And this is a Dometic refrigerator and freezer. This particular unit is going to run off of electric and LP, and if you switch it to the auto mode, when you go up here and switch it to auto, then it will switch back and forth between the power and the gas. So if you have any more questions, please contact me, 541-514-1332. My name is Mitch Ripke, and I do work off commission. Please contact me, and I'll be able to answer any more questions for you. Thank you.